Hello, I'm Robert Bastian of Laryngopedia and Bastian Voice Institute. By now, you are probably very well educated about the condition we call R-CPD, retrograde cricopharyngeal dysfunction. And in case not, please feel free to go to Laryngopedia and just type in R-CPD, and up comes a resource page with a tremendous amount of information to further educate you. My purpose today, though, is to talk to you about the visual explanation for this terrible disorder. And here we see three x-rays, and those three x-rays really explain why it is that people have severe daily misery from this terrible affliction. Now, these are three people who are in exaggerated level of misery, and that's why they went to an emergency room. The first two are in terrible distress. The third, though, is in crisis, and I want to explain the difference. But let's look first at this first x-ray. Just to orient you, I'm drawing a horizontal line here across the upper part of this massive air bubble in the stomach. Above the line that I'm drawing is what the size of a normal air bubble should be. In this case, there's this massive amount of air in the stomach. It is so large that it's even depressing. The transverse colon that you can see is also filled with air here, and then you see a huge amount of air in the descending colon that's ready to emerge as flatulence. So this person's x-ray explains the severe daily misery, the flatulence, the abdominal bloating, the abdominal distension in many people, and the gurgling sounds as the abdomen and GI tract try to get rid of that air upwards against an unyielding sphincter. So there in one picture is the explanation for the misery. The middle picture I'm showing just because it's such a nice view of the elevated hemidiaphragm on the left, right of photo. And that explains why some people who are very symptomatic say, I couldn't possibly go for a run. I just can't fill. I can't get enough air in because the diaphragm is lifted and they can't fill the chest as well. Now let's go to the third photo. Here's the man who's in an absolute crisis. What happened to him? He's 30-something. He's had RCPD all his life. He's never remembered being able to burp, but it became an issue in his late teens or early 20s. I forgot when. That's a common story where he began to have the real symptoms. Never could burp, but now he's really uncomfortable. So he's lived with this on a daily basis for years. Part of the picture for him is that he is constipated. And so this is taken on a day when he was very constipated. And he said, okay, took a lot of water, drank a lot of water, thinking that might get something going. That didn't work. And so then he did the wrong thing. He took a powerful laxative that is carbonated. It's called magnesium citrate. So he just blew up his stomach massively here with this air. Why is he in crisis? Well, remember, he's constipated, so he's not really able to pass gas. But also look at how part of his small and large intestines are sequestered way up here to the right by this massive air bubble in the stomach. And then the rest of his GI tract is kind of sequestered down here, all of it filled with air. And here you see the air wanting to get out, but being blocked. And so now not only can he burp, but he can't pass gas and he's in true misery. The solution in the emergency room, a nasogastric tube down into the stomach, relieve all that air, the GI contents reconfigure, get the constipation taken care of. Now he can again pass gas, and he's back to his sort of normal daily level of misery and not this crisis level of misery. Well, when I do a video like this, I'm always thinking about that individual out there who's anxious and worried about that this is going to happen to me. Well, the answer is no, it's not going to happen to you. As long as you don't do the wrong thing, get very constipated and then fill yourself with carbonation. Just don't do those two things and you will be, you will not get into this kind of a crisis. So RCPD, very treatable. There is a solution. So educate yourself additionally. Thank you for watching this video.